Verity. Actually, you know, let's look at our collector real quick. Should we get the cycler rifle? Actually, yeah, let's get iron shot so we can take down vehicles. And we can get the cycler rifle if we wanted to, which... No, let's not do it quite yet. You can always do it in between matches. And I guess we can only have, I guess we can only put the, I have an idea. Wait a minute, I was going to say we can put it in the top slot, but I can't. Or I can't look at that right now. Alright, then this, how much are these? Oh, they're not that expensive, so that's fine. Yeah, I'll definitely get that. I see that's, level 5, because it's pretty awesome. Alright. And now let's go over to Walker Assault. Now we can actually destroy the walkers. These abilities... you gotta remember that they're charges, and you find the charges on the ground. Basically, they're the lightning symbols that you see floating midair. They're floating right above the ground, so yeah. Yeah, you gotta pick those up in order to use the thing. That was like a pretty good tips, by the way, in the bottom left. All right, come on. There we go. And we do not want this on this map. That's not a good idea. We do want that though. Alright, let's do this. I really like this lobby screen, by the way. It's pretty good. You know, I guess very much done. Although the match starting thing, if you don't read that, and if you don't gather by that image as to where the match is, you probably will be very confused, as I kind of was when I first... When I first got the game, which was 2 days ago, so yeah. But once you realize that's where the match thing is, you're fine. Now this was actually, you know, this mode kind of was in the, kind of was in Battlefront 2, as the Hoth map, as the Grand Hoth map. However, unlike the original, instead of having to destroy the AT-ATs, they were there just for fun. They didn't really matter. Oh, I should have gotten a cycler rifle for this. Oh, I got the teammate stuff, so let's use our teammate stuff. Alright, yeah. Did you get him? I didn't get him. Enemies up ahead. Oh, wow. Oh, but we dealt damage. No, let's use our own. How many grenades for this? Yeah, but on the Hoth map, the AT-ATs were for sure winning, and when they got to your shield drain area, the match did not end, they just blew it up. I mean, not for sure, but for fun. However, in this game, they made it into a whole new game mode, and they made it really, really interesting. Also, Hoth, does Hoth look more similar to the movies than it did in Battlefront 2? I think it does. Because if you remember the movies, it was, I mean, basically Battlefront 2 is just the, at the base area. However, in this it's much more. Where are the enemies? And not like in Battlefront 2 where the trenches were just kind of there because, however, in this game they're useful. Oh, we got snipers. Didn't get that one. There's some enemies. Oh, snow. Man, this game awesome. Ah, oh, I'm harder than you a little bit. Oh, that guy's back. Man, he's angry. Oh, he owned me and made me use a charge, that jerk. He made me use a charge. And I'm not used to getting owned by AT-ATs or ATSTs like that. I'm pretty sure that wasn't like that in Battlefront 2 anyway. I did use a charge. Oh, that's not good. One grenade. Ah! That's really... You think, you know, like, I think I just gotta get used to how the AT-ATs are. I'm just wasting charges. That's not... I don't know how I feel about that. If you, like, if you think you're good, and then you hold Y and then use your charge in order to get the, Iron Blaster ant, or in order to get the Iron Blaster in your gun, and then the AT-ST just kills you, I guess I just need to be more careful with it, but still. I just feel kind of weird. And also these charges, like, I think you get 10 charges per match, and then you have to unlock them in the... How did they do that? How did he live? He was just one shot away, and I shot him like 3 times, and then he didn't go down. Oh boy. Oh, this is a world difference. Yeah. Ah! I remember how much health you do not have in this game. And it spawned me over here, really? What? Oh yeah, I wish I could choose my spawn, it'd be really nice. Instead of just choosing a random spawn or your partner spawn, I wish you could choose which side of the map you want to spawn on. That would really help. Oh, almost ready. Got it. Kind of a waste, but I just picked another one up, so it's okay. Oh, this guy. Ow. Oh, I guess iron charges don't work on soldiers. Oh, please, don't lose me. This is going to be fair trouble. Oh, look, a green. Oh, I threw it too far. Yeah. There's ADST. I wish there was snow speeders in this. Make things a whole lot easier. Maybe that's why there's not. Can I use that? Make it prone. He's gone.
Bomber targeting systems locked in.
Yeah, all these spacecraft you see, they're all piloted, I think. Like, those guys are piloted and stuff like that. So I'm not quite sure how you get into one.
Airstrike incoming.
Alright, I just gotta hold out till then. I think he's followed it as well. I'll say that name up there is the guy's following it. Get oh, it's a proton. Okay, grenade. Oh, perfect. Grenade. Oh, still shoot. As long as it's going, we're good. Grenade out. No, yeah. Suck it. Suck freedom. Oh, wait for it. Suck freedom. That's gonna blow up on him. Or not. Oh, yeah. Get right, ADSD. Yeah, let's do even more of this. Because it worked really well. And then grenade. There you go. Yeah, they unpack one of the vehicles, I guess. Oh, this guy's going down. The other one's taking a lot of damage as well. Yeah, finally. You basically just get a lot of bombers and then use them. As long as I don't get shot from the side or back, I'm good. Finally someone took me out. After I basically just owned that ATSD. Oh, they spawned me, that's a yes! Oh, wrong. Ah, from my car. Alright, we got it. Oh, that was close. Oh, no. I want this. Oh, he's out. Yeah, the bomb, the strike, airstrike is out. Ah. But wow, can you do all that damage to the ATSD if you just shoot inside once it's stunned? Right now. Oh, there we go. You just find these things on the map, I guess. Let's try it out. It'll be my favorite. The uplink station has been activated. Alright, here I go. Alright, let's try not to explode. And or suck. Oh! Okay, yeah. I thought it wasn't reversed there for a second for some reason. He's gone. I don't know. I feel it should be normalized instead of being inverted. It's me though. The uplink is down. We'll lose bomber support if we do not get it back online. Yeah, A-wings, I love them. All right, where is it? You are. What should we be looking at? Oh, missing the A-wing. Y-wing targeting systems locked in. Alright, just go. The uplink station has been activated. Hold it. Alright, now let's go around and try to find people. Because you can't really turn your camera at all. Oh wow. Just wanna buzz around a little bit. Oh, you know why I think it's weird? Because it's using arcade flight controls. It's not using a similar style. As in you don't have the you can't yaw, you just turn. So that's probably why I think it's better reversed. I think it's better inverted. Where are all the TIE fighters? Oh, that's one of ours, yeah. As Rebels always have the weirder ships. I kinda want to invert my controls. Or uninvert my controls. Oh well. Are they stunned? I can't tell. Yeah, I'm going over here. Oh, spin this. Ah, I couldn't maneuver in time. No, well. Well, now that we got a chance, let's uninvert. Yeah, let's uninvert. Oh, well. Oh, now they come. Now they come. Walker down. The walker is defenseless. Yeah, let's figure out what they are. We got killed. Oh, we got that one. Yeah, shoot me! Ah, I couldn't aim in time. So many games. Oh, that's a bad place to put me. That's a very bad place to put me. I should have thrown a grenade on the guy that I took out, and then took the other one out normally. Remember, we just gotta kill the AT-AT. That's all we gotta do. Wow. Well, yeah, the air combat's really nice. I mean, the flying combat's very nice in this game. The go too long. Just getting one of these. That didn't do much. That didn't reach at all. Where's our uplinks? Over there.
We have activated an uplink station. Prepare for enemy counterattack.
Oh, there's another AT. Okay, wing. Yeah, you can have it. It's interesting that the A-wings are just running power-ups on the map, or the fighters are just running power-ups on the map. That's an interesting design decision. I'm not quite sure how I feel about it, actually. Grenade out. And he got into a turret. One of our turrets. Ah. You were lucky, sir. You were lucky. Also, you had a bigger gun than me. Oh, there are small speeders on this. I guess I just can't use their tow cables. Yeah, that's the thing about Battlefront 2, is you can tow cable their, on the health map where you do have AT-ATs, you can get into a small speeder, which is the only spacecraft for the rebels, or for the rebels on that map. And, you can tow cable their legs. Which is interesting that they're not in this, but then again, you know, they decided to have Walker Assault be a major game type instead of just being more of an extra thing that they've thrown to a map because it would be cool. So yeah. I mean, because it's cool. Or something like that. What's going on, guy? No, that's going on. Oh, no, no. Oh, no. That was close. Hey, are they going to get wide? Are they going to ask why when you get owned? Oh, no. Great. That was cycler. That's cycler because he's shooting blasters at me now. Ah. I tried halo jumping. Oh, he doesn't love me. That's from. Well, there's my from. Are there any ships around here? Actually, I saw one. Oh, they got jerk move. They took it. They activated one of those. Ah, he has standard one. I have standard one. Oh, in that situation, I had the upper hand. I just fired way late. Gotcha. Well, that means I'm my friend. I'm not the only one that walks above the trenches. What? My shot looked like it was a little laggy that time. It was a little slow. Oh wow, that's a problem. Come on, Y-Wings, we need ya. You could probably take him out. Look at those star destroyers. If only you could fly up to him. Actually, can you? Probably not. I mean, they're in atmosphere, so... But when you think about it, these space battles? I don't actually like the films, are they? Because there's only... How many space battles were in the original trilogy? Like, one for each film? And most of the action happened on the ground, so... Yeah. Oh, yeah, we did! Victory! Yeah! So, yeah, I mean... Not, just because there's no space combat doesn't mean it can't be Star Wars. So, yeah. I got 18th place, so that's actually kind of terrible, but I helped a lot destroying Moonwalker a little bit, so yeah. Dang, I'm on guess 4, alright. Yeah, that's going to take a while though. Actually, not really. If we play more Hooker, so I won't. Oh, yeah. Alright, let's grab the, now let's make this a permanent weapon. And by the way, now that I think about it, the models for Clone Wars could have been put in this game, as all they gotta do is just take the model from the movies and make it into a game model, which is not too difficult. Sure. Actually, yes, very much so. I'm recommending to these guys, is that not good enough? Alright, let's have a unique PS experience. And make my expectations. Maybe, yeah, probably, yeah. Yeah, I'm definitely going with game delivers a Star Wars fantasy fulfillment, because it does. It does indeed. The game has a unique FPS experience, because it does, you know, like, how I describe it is a Battlefield Halo Battlefront experience. Basically how that works. And even then, it has things that the other games don't. I mean, the card system in Star Wars, in Halo 5 will be just, it'll be just to unlock stuff. It won't be, or it'll be just consumable to unlock stuff in game. For the most part, although they're going to be, customization options, like different armors and different colors and stuff like that you can get, through the, cards. But for the most part, they're just a way to unlock stuff in the certain multiplayer mode. So yeah, this game does feel unique. This game graphics are perfect. No, they work extremely. They are just as what you would think they are. So they've definitely met my expectations. And game delivers Star Wars fantasy fulfillment. Yes, like I've been saying from the first video, it's the only star. It's, I guess I should say this now. Basically, this game just feels like Star Wars. It feels like you're in the middle of a movie. Unlike other Star Wars games, which actually kind of all of them to me anyway, all the ones I played are good, but they don't feel like you're in a movie. They feel Star Wars, yeah, but they don't feel like you're actually in one of the movies. This game actually does that very, very well. So yeah, and I'll submit that. There you go. All right, but anyway, so yeah, that'll be it for these videos. So thanks for watching. That'd be it for this session. Thank you for watching. I really appreciate you guys watching this video or watching these videos. It means a lot to me. You can also be honest with me to leave a comment if you would like to have any suggestions for the series, or yeah, if you have any suggestions for the series, like what game types you want to do next, or tips on how to play Star Wars Battlefront in general, or Star Wars Battlefront beta in general. Even if our no tip stream is coming through, below that do no tip. And I guess, but I do really appreciate you guys watching this series. It is one of my more popular ones right now, and yeah. I'll definitely be doing this when Star Wars Battlefront coming out again. Let me look at my trusty notepad on my computer. November 17th, so yeah, I'll definitely be playing this a lot when it comes out. So yeah, this game just, it's amazing in every way imaginable. In all the ways that make sense, it is amazing. So yeah, they really outdone themselves, DICE did. So we'll see if, you know, there's a thing that people have is whether or not this will have a bad launch, like Battlefield 4 did. But just to remind you guys, it was just Battlefield 4. Battlefield Hardline had an excellent launch, Battlefield 3 had an excellent launch. This beta has had an excellent launch so far, so it might have an excellent launch when it comes out, and even if it doesn't, Battlefield 4 was fixed on Xbox in 3 months. Which is not a good thing, that's terrible, that it'd be fixed at all. But, you know, it still was fixed fast, so, yeah. And the pre-order benefits from GameStop, anyway, is getting access to the map pack before anyone else. And it comes with the game, the map pack for, the new movie. Definitely worth it. The game right now is just perfect right now, and you know, with its limited game modes and its limited maps, and its limited everything, it's limited beta. It's still, you know, you can see what else there is, and yeah, it's just gonna be awesome when it comes out, or at least I should hope so. Anyway, definitely play it when it comes out. Am I saying this will be the last video I'm saying this will be the last video for this playlist, for the beta. It may be. We'll see if I can record, we'll see if I can record one more tomorrow, and see if I can record a couple tomorrow, but we shall see. Alright, but anyway, so, yeah, that'll be it for today, and I guess, see you in a second.